Well, folks, it's the off season, and here's our first offer. The Blue Jays are offering us a 1-year contract for $1.7 million as a Major League Baseball starter. So the question is, do we want to take it? I don't see a reason why not. Like, it's a pretty good deal for 1 year, $1.7 million for 1 year. And it's only our third year. Well, we're going into our third year. We've only played 2 years so far of the game. So I say, hey, why not? Take it, play it, see what we get the next year. So I'm going to advance and sign the deal. So are you sure you want to sign this 1-year contract deal for 1.7? Actually, you know what? I'm going to see if I can get 2 million out of these guys. We'll see what we can do if we can get 2 million. See if they'll take our 2 million offer. So there we go. They countered with 1.875. So let's try 1.95. The Blue Jays aren't able to accept your terms, but they're willing to offer you for 1.925. All right, so they come up some for us. So by negotiating, we've actually been able to bring it up from 1.7 to 1.925. So there you have it. We have a good contract now. So we're going to accept this one. It's almost 2 million for a year, and it's only our third year, and that's 1 year, people. 1 year, we get $1.925 million. So I'm going to take it. Heck yes, it's a great deal in my opinion. So yes, we're taking that. All right, welcome to season 3. Here's the first game. We're the starter of it. This season, as you saw, we are now making $1.925 million for the season, which is awesome for us. That's pretty damn good. I can't wait till our rookie little bit is done, so we can do longer contracts for larger amount of money. So here's your lineup for today. It's Jose Reyes, Michael Saunders, myself, Victor Mendoza, Mohammed Tidwell, Josh Reddick, CJ Crone, Ben Zubris, and Bruce Michael. And so looks like to me, I don't think we traded for anyone in the off season. Nothing came up on my thing saying that we traded for anyone. CJ Crone, looks like he's come up from the minors to play this game, because he was a minor all-star. So let's jump in and play the first game of season number 3, 2017.
Back here on a special opening day edition of the MLB pregame show. Matt Vaskersian here, counting down the minutes until the new season gets underway. And before it does, we'll check out our first Topps player spotlight. Ryan Bull is in that spotlight. And one of the reasons we're watching him is he was a run-producing machine last season, leading the American League in RBIs.
But of course, you can't drive in runs if there aren't base runners, so some credit has to go to his teammates, but not too much credit. Now, he's the one who came through when his team needed him, and he'll be the one opposing managers will have to worry about come game time. Now, last year, he proved to have the intangible clutch skill, so he'll look to keep that going this year.
All right, lineups and first pitch are coming up next. Stay tuned for that right here on the show.
All right, opening day, boys.
From the Warehouse District and Target Field here in downtown Minneapolis, Opening day is here as we get the new season underway with a good matchup between the Toronto Blue Jays and the Minnesota Twins. Hi again, everybody. It's finally here. Welcome to our special opening day edition of Baseball on the Show. I'm joined by Eric Harris and Steve Lyons. And Steve, as we get set to get things going, it's the pitching that has to be considered one of the strong points on this ball club.
Yeah, and pitching is going to be important for these guys. No question about it. They're only going to go as far as this group right here is going to take them. And to me, it looks like a staff that's capable of getting the job done.
The game's count starting now. It's opening day. It's the show. And it's coming up next.
There's Jose Bautista. Man, I wish he was still on Toronto for us.
The crowd is ready to erupt as their guys get set to take the field. Let's join public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now, your 2018 Minnesota Twins.
There's your pitchers for day.
With that, a look at John Gibbons' lineup for the visiting Blue Jays. Steve, what's their focus as they go for their first win?
Well, the wind is blowing in today, so you're not going to see a lot of long drives. Focus on hitting the ball on a line and on the ground to score your runs today.
Phil Hughes gets the call to pitch here on opening day in front of the hometown crowd. What do we need to know here, EK?
Well, Matty, remember last year, he had an ERA in the low threes. Very dependable, very consistent. One of the most reliable pitchers in the game.
All right, let's start this
and
game.
With a quick breather here, let's give you a look at how the Twins stack up defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic. Any thoughts, Eric?
Well, guys, Brian Dozier doesn't get enough attention for his defense. He's known for his offense and hitting home runs from second base, but he's also provided this team with.
Into the box now, Ryan Bull. He'll get to take his first cuts here.
All right, 1-0 already, one on, no outs.
Line hard.
There's our first
right
hit.
Center. In there, a base
season,
hit.
And there we go. That's pretty good. A base hit for our first. Hit of
well,
the season
extends his streak to lucky number 13 now. That's almost two full weeks where he's been swinging it.
That's from carried over from last season. Because if any of you know, I don't play spring training or preseason or anything like that in any of my sports.
He'll get his first opportunity in this one.
Come on, don't double.
Hughes comes set. Here's the nothing and two. Pitch
oh,
outside the
curve. Oh, shit, you did shit.
Safe at second base. And he is out.
You should have went, jackass.
The tag on him.
Damn it. I was hoping you'd take.
Ryan
go for
Bull
it.
Is into the box as we are all set to begin the third.
Well, guys,
all right, 4-0 for us.
Big lead early on in this game, but you really can't get comfortable. You have to keep putting pressure on.
Hughes is ready. First pitch on its way. Hits this one hard.
And
the
I'm
way.
Out.
There is Dozier. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
Well, so we're at 50%
right
so
there.
Far
I mean, this,
this
is a
this season.
Fastball right down the middle. And he just smokes this ball, too. But unfortunately, he hits it right at someone. So it becomes a fairly easy out.
Ryan Bull will step in now to lead off the inning as his guys look to maybe break the rut they've been
all right,
stuck
4-2.
In.
4-2.
Yeah, and after that
top
first
of the
inning,
six.
It's been
no one out, no one
cents.
On.
And once he kind of got settled into that groove, he's been a difficult nut to crack.
Well, we'll crack him. All right. So it was a good position.
Hughes looks in. Here's just the first pitch.
There we go. There we go.
To right center. Back goes Bautista.
First home run of the season for us. There you go, folks. First game, first home run.
Solo shot to right center. And just like that, it's now a 5-2 ball game.
About the only silver lining to this one from a defensive point of view is it came with the bases empty leading off an inning. You can survive it when this guy's hitting solo shots.
Ryan Bull will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here, a solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ball game to this point.
All right, give me something right there again. I got two people on base, two outs. I want something good.
He's set. Here it comes. In the air to
center field. All right, another home run. No doubter. Three-run home run, baby.
So a three-run blast to deep center here. His second of the game, as it's now a six-run ball game.
Well, it seems to me like we've seen this before. His second home run of the ball game, and it would seem to me that he hit that one harder than he did the last one, so he's definitely locked in.
Well, you gotta say, I'm worth that 1.9.
Ryan Bull will get another shot at it here as we take you back to inning number 7. This was his second home run of the ball game, as he'd like nothing more than to make it 3 right here.
This keeps up, you bet your ass I'm asking for $2 million next year.
High and deep to left center field. Arcia
going back. That one we're probably out.
Still going back. He makes the catch. What a play on the run to end the inning. One left for Toronto. They won't add to their 9-6 lead.
And that should be the end of the game. Unless they come back and get 3 points. And there you have it. Looks like we won. Yes, we did. 9-6. We got 3 hits out of 5. Pretty good start to the season.
So a good offensive showing for these guys. But if we had to pick one player that stood out, that's our man right there. He's our Topps player of the game.
And you have to feel good for that guy right there. The games finally count, and he comes out on opening day and turns in a great performance. Now, that's how you want to get your season started.
Damn right. 2 home runs, 4 RBIs. Can't complain about that for
so
opening
just
day.
So that'll just about do it. For Eric Caro, Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshownation.com. The Blue Jays
Marcus
come
Stroman
out on
gets
top,
the win.
9-6.
For the Twins, 6 runs, 11 hits, 1 error.
All right, let's continue this series.
Both teams getting their final warm-ups in as we welcome you back to the MLB pregame show. First pitch of game 2 in our series is right around the corner. But before we turn that corner, here is our Topps player spotlight. Ryan Bull will be in the glow, coming off a last game in which he was really outstanding in the clutch moments, collecting a whole bucket full of RBI. So he'll be looking to emulate that type of performance here again in this one.
Yeah. And you said it, Matt. He was clutch. And you know, some guys just have that uncanny ability to come through when it really matters. In baseball, it's usually when there are runners in scoring position, and he found himself up in that situation a number of times. It was pretty special to watch him out there, so I'm excited to see what he does to back it up.
Okay, Eric, Steve, and I are ready for baseball, and we'll have it for you next on the show. MLB The Show's coverage of Wednesday Night Baseball finds us at Target Field in Minneapolis. Time for Game 2 of the regular season between the Toronto Blue Jays and the Minnesota Twins. Welcome in, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian here to bring you this early season matchup. I'm joined by Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, as we get set to get things going, it's the pitching that has to be considered one of the strong points on this ball club.
Yeah, and pitching's going to be important for these guys, no question about it. They're only going to go as far as this group right here is going to take them. And to me, it looks like a staff that's capable of getting the job done.
Set for what should be a good one. Lineups and first pitch are next.
All right, so we have Hutchinson as our opener. He's been doing pretty good for us last season.
Back now as we draw ever closer to first pitch, let's listen in to public address announcer Mike Carlucci.
And now, your Minnesota Twins.
There's your lineup for the starters.
Now a moment as we take a look at the Jays starting nine for this one. Eric Karros, who you focused on?
Well, guys, everybody should be looking out for that guy in the number three spot. He put on one of the most impressive displays of power in recent memory last season. He hit 60 home runs. He's the kind of player that wins ball games and sells tickets.
Clay Buchholz, a right-hander from the state of Texas, is the man on the mound.
Objective is to break the 60 this year.
Well, guys, remember last year he had an ERA.
Especially now that we're a starter.
Very solid, very dependable.
And with that, let's give you a look at how the Twins stack up defensively. It's brought to us by Majestic.
EK, all right-handers again.
His nickname is Joey Bats, but Jose Bautista, he can play some serious defense as well. But I'll tell you, the arm is as good as anybody's in the game. We've seen him.
Ryan Bull gets his first opportunity now in the top of the first with nobody on.
Yeah, and you don't want to set the early tone here by letting him cruise through the first inning. You've got to at least put up a little bit of a fight in this at-bat.
Oh, that's well hit.
Deep but center it's field. Going to be out.
Grichuk ranging back, still ranging back.
All right, go. Home run right off the first hit.
So it's a solo shot to dead center as the Jays get the game's first tally. It's 1-0.
Well, it's got to be getting near the point where they need to make some alternate plans with this guy up there. Now, that's his third home run in the series. I mean, what more do you need to see?
A lot more, because we want to break the 60 mark that we made last
season. Stepping
in
and ready for another shot.
All right, 2-2.
Bull, as the switch hitter will take
top of the third, one out. No one on base. Come on, we need some people on.
Buckhold
base for me.
Sign. First pitch on the way. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble.
There we go. Good for two.
He'll take the turn and head for second.
And we'll stay at two.
And he's two for two as he's in there with a double.
Yeah, real good extension on the swing that time as he goes out and gets that ball. You'll see the right fielder's got no shot at this one as it's over his head and one hops the wall out there. That's going to allow him to coast into second with an easy double.
Coming to the plate now, Victor Mendoza. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here.
Oh, and it's so important to take advantage of these kind of opportunities early in a ball game. It can change the entire complexion of the game if you can put the other guys on their heels right away.
And that's through into right field for a base hit. On Batista's throw,
damn
it,
is
right on the money. He
I'm
is
out.
Out at home plate.
Yeah, and you just have to know your outfield arms out there, especially out in right field. You can see him chugging around third base.
Well, if I didn't stop at third, I would have been
good. A good throw here
good.
Is going to nail him trying to score.
If I didn't pause at third, I would have been fine.
Ryan
oh, well.
Bull
here's another chance.
Box now, launched one over the wall back in the opening frame.
One out again. Top of the fifth. No one on.
Hit hard back up the middle.
Good for one
and
base.
And into center field as he's aboard with a one-out single.
Well, he's homered. He's doubled, and now he adds a single to that total. He's left himself with the toughest leg of the cycle remaining, but he'll at least have a chance to pick up that fourth and final leg next time through the order.
Victor Mendoza will stride in, popped out and singled in his two trips.
Yeah, and he made just a little adjustment last time coming off of that pop-up the first time around, and he got himself a base knock. That's what the good ones do.
Ground ball right side.
Oh, shoot.
And he'll take this over to the bag for the out. But meanwhile, the runner moves into
okay.
scoring
good.
Position at
good,
second.
Good, good. It bounced.
Yeah, and here with the runner who's on
for
the
a second,
move,
I thought it didn't
no
bounce. I was like, shit.
Thinking about getting the double play. So a smart idea there just to take the sure out at first.
Muhammad Tidwell will stand in for the third time now. Still without a hit, so that streak could be in a bit of jeopardy.
And I think that's in the back of his mind, but it's not something he's really focused on. He just wants to get up there and put a good swing on the ball.
All right, Muhammad. Bring me home. Let's take this lead.
And now the runner's trying for third. Hit to third. Nunez takes it in. Throw on to Maurer will be in time, and that retires the side. One hit, one left. Home half of the fifth coming up, and we are tied 2-2.
All right. Let's break this tie.
We'll stand in again, but first we'll flash you back to the very first inning of the ballgame. And here you go, a solo home run that had him off and running early on.
Oh, okay, we're up by two. And we have two people on, two outs. Let's bring
trying
these guys
to keep
home.
The game close. Here's the pitch. Oh, and he turns another one
and
around.
There we
here.
Go. No
and
doubter home run. Three runs. Oh, yeah, baby. That's four. Four for the season already.
So a three-run shot to left center. His second home run of the game. And the lead is now 7-2.
We're starting off this season awesome.
Well, it seems to me like we've seen this before. His second home run of the ball game, and it would seem to me that he hit that one harder than he did the last one, so he's definitely locked in.
Ryan Bull will stand in to lead things off here, and can you believe it? A tie ball game again.
Holy shit.
This game's had more ups and downs than my 401k.
We gotta do something here.
We've got some more.
No outs, no one on. But we gotta do something to take the lead. So it'd be good to have two wins in our under our belt at the beginning of the season.
Oh, and look at this.
There we go. Another home run.
And when this ball comes down, they'll have taken the lead. Home run.
There we go. Five for the season.
A solo shot here to straightaway right field. His third home run of the ball game as they grab an 8-7 lead in this seesaw game.
Boy, have a night. His third home run of the ball game. I mean, he's absolutely brimming with confidence at the plate. Been a joy to watch so far.
All right, so we didn't get the cycle, but we did get three home runs. And there you go. It's the end of the game. We won it by one. That last home run by me takes the lead and gives us a 2-0.
An entertaining game all in all. So if we have to choose one who
stats for the beginning of the season,
why not go with this man right here? He's our top player of the game.
Five RBIs.
Like everything he touched turned to gold. Winds up with five hits in the game. Without question, a standout performance.
Perfect game for us. Awesome.
So that's a wrap here tonight. Eric Karros, Steve Lyons, Matt Vasgersian, you've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Facebook at Out on Top 87. Good night from Minneapolis.
They left 14 men on base.
All right, next game of the series.
Back here on the MLB pregame show, Matt Vasgersian getting you set for the finale of this three-game set. That'll come your way in mere moments, but first we'll take a look at the Topps player spotlight. Ryan Bull will be our focus, and he had the long ball working in his last game. Three home runs, really carrying his team on his back.
Yeah, we see it maybe a couple times a year, but when a guy gets three homers in a game, it's always worth talking about. He got some good pitches to hit, and he just flat out did not miss them. I mean, I've seen guys put fewer out in a home run derby round, so he's clearly got plenty of power in that swing of his, and who knows, maybe he'll put on another show in this one. I wouldn't put it past him.
Okay, we're looking forward to this one. Lineups and first pitch on the show coming up next. Now from the land of 10,000 lakes, we've got afternoon baseball from Target Field in Minneapolis. Game number three of this new season between the Toronto Blue Jays and the Minnesota Twins. These two should provide some big-time fireworks. First pitch is coming up. With that, a look at John Gibbons' lineup for the visiting Blue Jays. Steve, what do they need to do to complete the sweep?
Well, they have lots of power, but also lots of speed in that lineup as well. So you need to stay out of the double play situations and work counts.
Ricky Nolasco, the California-born right-hander, is on the mound. EK, what's the word on him?
Well, guys, remember, he's not a lot of fun to face because he's got five pitches. As a hitter, you've got to worry about the ball coming in, moving away, the speed.
Ryan Bull will stride forward now, and one would imagine he'll be pitched to very carefully as he's coming off a three home run ball game a night ago. Nolasco's
right,
two
ready. Out, no
here
one
comes
on.
The first pitch. Sliced hard on the ground.
And there we
and
go.
The
good for
continue as that's
a single.
For a two out hit.
I've been really impressed with the way he's swinging the bat lately. 15 straight games now, and people are really starting to take notice of that streak.
Victor Mendoza will get his first shot here. Two hits in five trips a night ago. A runner on first with two away. Runners off for second. Hit the other way out toward right field. And here's Grichuk to make the catch, and the side is retired. Blue Jays held in check, and now the Twins will go to work on offense. We've got no score.
All right, let's go to our next up.
Settling in now. Ryan
still nothing,
Bull
nothing. One on base.
From the left side right
one
here.
Out. Bull. Top of the third.
Oh,
there we go. Stay
deep.
Fair. Stay
that
fair.
Is a moonshot, folks.
And
a
that's a no doubter. Two-run home run.
A two-run blast to straightaway right field. Sixth home run on the season for him as the Blue Jays take a 2-0 advantage.
That pitcher's got to be thinking, how can I throw a pitch like that in this situation? That thing was so right down the middle, it absolutely got hammered, and he knew it as soon as he let go of it.
All right, our season's starting awesome.
Leading off the inning.
But we're down by one now.
They'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
Well, you know, he's been on base twice in this one already, so let's see if he can do it again.
All right,
Nolasco,
give me something good.
His sign. Here's the first pitch. Stung into the gap in right
there
center.
There we go.
What should be extra bases.
We're good for two.
Around first, heading for second now.
We'll
and
stay
he is
here
in the second base with a double. His third hit this afternoon.
Well, he's right on the fastball here. You get a look. He gets that bat head out front and just rips his ball into the alley and right. Gets the inning started with a nice leadoff double.
So striding in, number nine, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield.
Come on, Victor, do something good here.
Trying to hold the lead. This is hit high in the air and pretty deep down the left field line. Garcia ranges deep into the corner to
make
the catch for the first down.
Come here.
Fly ball to left's not going to do you any good in this situation. Look, you got a guy on second and nobody out. If you take this to right field and advance a runner, then at least you've made a productive.
Muhammad Tidwell stands in. He got under one and popped out his last time up.
Come on, another double for you. Another double.
Here's a swing and a high pop-up.
Jesus Christ.
Palmeiro camps under it, and he's got it for out number two.
Well, anytime you get an RBI guy to the plate with less than two outs, and he does that, he is not happy. That's the kind of at-bat that'll stick with you for a while.
Josh Reddick will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Has to be thinking strikeout here. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. One left for Toronto. Still a 3-2 ball game.
All right, we can come back.
Ryan Bull will stride in, but first we take you back to the third as you take another look here at his two-run homer that had him rolling early on.
All right, no one on base, one out, tied game.
Now here's a shot out toward the gap in
that
right center.
That should be good for double.
Around first, on his way to second now.
And I'll stay here at second.
And he is into second base with one away as the go-ahead run.
Here's another look at this swing in show motion. Check out the hands getting into good position. The hips start to rotate and then whack. That's great extension all the way through the ball. That's the perfect swing right there.
Victor Mendoza digs in, looking to send something into the outfield that gives that go-ahead run a chance to score from second.
Well, no complaints on this end, guys. You've got to love any game that's this tight, this late.
Hit to short. Glove by Santana. Throw gets him. Two down.
At least you got it on the ground for me to move forward this time, Victor.
Now batting, third baseman, Mohammed.
Come on, Muhammad. Bring me home. Bring me home.
In. He got under one and popped out his last time up. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with two down. Ground ball left side. Backhanded.
Get safe.
And a close play at the bag.
Damn it.
But a good stretch by the first baseman got the out, and the inning is over. Blue Jays held in check, still tied 3-3.
We're getting more hits, but we're not bringing in any extra.
So standing.
All right,
in,
so they're winning.
Bull, and we'll see if he can get something into the gap to make it interesting. He's had a great game so far, but needs the triple to complete a cycle.
And you know, that's the toughest one to get in a cycle, but you can bet that he's going to try to stretch any double into a triple if he gets any chance at all.
Hot shot.
And we're out.
Throw on to first for the out, and that is how the ninth inning gets underway.
Well, this is what you want out of your closer. Comes in firing darts, and it's a very quick out number one.
So that's probably game. Well, maybe not. Yep, they won it this one. So our stats are now 2-1, which is all right for opening series.
And fellas,
we took
as
the series.
Always, a few guys we could have chosen from, but out of everybody, that's the man who stands out in my book. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, he only had one hit, but he definitely made it count. Big home run that turned
good
out
for
to be
the Twins. They got their first win of the series,
so
of the game,
just about do it
season,
for us this afternoon.
And
to Eric
we got
Carroll,
two
Steve
wins
Lyons
of the season.
Of our crew.
So
Matt this has
we'll
been
see
a
you
of
in the next
the
one.
Find out more, head on over to the show.
Our next video will be our home opener back in Toronto. So see you then. Take care.
So
keep on swinging.